It's very exciting. I mean, you know, proper London premiere for the film, get it out there, you know, into the world. You know, hopefully people will enjoy what they see. We understood right from the word go that the original is a beloved, you know, classic of British cinema. But I think we couldn't go into it kind of thinking too much about that. It's a new story. We very much wanted to honour the spirit of the original film, but they're new children. It's a film about evacuees in the Second World War. But, you know, I think there were so many nods to the original that and the tone of it is very much like the original. So I hope people, you know, enjoy this follow-on. I think what's useful about doing a film like this is that even though it's a children's story and it is an adventure, there are lots of themes. There are lots of, like, you know, interesting themes that you can play around with that are important to kids, you know, to do with good and evil, to do with standing up for what you believe in, to do with unity, in a way, in a time of crisis, which all of which are as relevant now as they, you know, as they ever were, and certainly when the original was made, you know.
How important was it for you and the rest of the team to have Jenny back on board as this iconic character?
Well, listen, if Jenny hadn't been on board, the film probably wouldn't have happened, because, you know, nor would we have wanted it to happen. Jenny was such an important part of, you know, coming back, making the Railway Children happen, and, you know, having her in it to as you know, a sort of maternal figure to these new children was vital. Well, we've got Sheridan, who, you know, I worked with twice last year, so that was, you know, a pleasure. Tom Courtenay, obviously legend, you know, and then of course we've got, you know, all the new kids, which, you know, I mean, the film would live or die by how good the children are, really, in truth. And I think they're all brilliant. I mean, first and foremost, you hope that it stands alone as a film in its own right and a story in its own right, whether you've seen the original or whether you've never seen the original. And if it doesn't, then we've failed, obviously. But I hope that people who have seen the original understand that we're not trying to replicate the original. That will always be a sort of beloved classic. But what we're trying to do is just, you know, honour the spirit of it and move it on and bring it forward to 2022, you know, in a way. And I think, hopefully, we've done that.
And talking about moving on, is there anything else you're moving on to the rest of this year and beyond?
I mean, on a personal level, I'm doing a series for the BBC called £10 Poms. So that's my next thing. Another period piece, actually.
Tell us any more about that, just quickly.
Yeah, it's set in 1956, and it's about when English people, British people, went over to Australia on the assisted migration scheme, you know, and they were not quite as welcome as they thought they were going to be.